Hey yo, welcome to my channel Caterpillar Junhang. I'm here now in our garage. As you can see, this video is regarding about the software or configuration, how to copy the configured program of the machine to save. And once did you install the new software to the new ECM, they just only reprogram through the reconfiguration system to configure the whole system of to put the good configuration. Okay, so and also shout out for you, Brad. This is the video for you. Okay, sorry about it's late. I hope that it can help this video. Okay, okay, boss, request mo na patungkol dun sa regarding about how to copy the how to copy the configuration of this of the ECM, like for example Gorilla, sorry. Now syempre, before you started, you have to open up, or if you have the ET of the Caterpillar, so you have to follow the instruction. At first, plug here. Plug the adapter to the data link. Okay, data link socket. So, and then you will see the adapter is going to light, indicating that the power is available to the port of a data link. So that time you started to switch on, so you can see switch on the unit and also your laptop, and then plug the USB cable. Okay, now it's already read the system, so it's completely read. Okay, the ECM machine controller, monitor, and main BIMS main module. So at first, at anyone, you can click any one of that system to open up on the ET. So okay, the first step, if you want to copy, like for example, the engine ECM, this engine ECM, okay, C9, you go at the service. Okay, service, click the service and then copy configuration, and then select ECM replacement, where the place you are going to save. Okay, now this ECM replacement is showing. That's all that this list is all I copied before. Okay, you have to cancel that. Okay, yes, meaning we will have to copy the now this machine. Okay, this machine we will copy it through why once that the selected item that you want to copy, it is going a highlight and click OK, so they will automatically copy it. Before you do the procedure of reflashing, this is a safety and if you are going to replace the original ECM, or if something happened to the original ECM, it's not functioning well, there's something problem in the original ECM, you want to replace any other one. So this is the way, or the first way you can do, just to copy the configuration of the old ECM if you can possible to copy. Okay, before you do the flushing or replushing or reinstallation or replacement of the ECM, just in case. Okay, now this is the ECM configure the program. Okay, one more thing, warning, once you do the replacing or reprogram of the new ECM, do not registered equipment ID. That is good for the next time you are going to reprogram it again, so you didn't need to use the factory password. Okay, make it sure that on the new ECM, you don't need to register the serial model number. Okay, so that's it. And then to save this file, okay, you go on the save file. Okay, edit this portion. It is a engine, like for example engine ECM, and the other side you don't need to remove the serial number because that is the for you to identify that the same machine, the same unit, the same serial number you are going to reprogram or reconfigure to the new ECM that you are going to install. Okay, so you just put, like for example, model of this machine 336, okay, D, and then space. Or if you have a plate number, also you put at here front, and then after that, if you already understand and clear to you that once this you already save, so you can easily located this number that you are going to install or reconfigure to the new ECM. Because once did you reprogram the ECM or replacing, if you are confused that there we need to update the ECM, so you need to reinstall or reconfigure at the same configuration. You know why? Sometimes you don't have any equipment for a timing, engine timing calibration, injector calibration. You don't have a what we call the trimming in trimming for the injector. So this is the easy way and good way by doing the reflushing. Okay, and then save. So now very successfully saved. So that's the process. And one more thing, what I told before, you don't need to do this process, okay, when flushing, or else maybe you erased. If you are not familiar or you are not totally understand very well about the doing the replacing or reprogram of this machine or any type of machine of the Caterpillar, so you don't need to come this process or to enter this process, or else the plus file or the program of this machine will be deleted if something's happened that you never want, or you don't like, or you never expect that you touch something, and then it can cause of the same as the movement oil. Yeah, like for example, now this is the replacing area. Okay, so replacing area, choose the file that you want here, click this side. Like for example, you have a new ECM, engine ECM, you want to reprogram, click this side. And then if you have the plus file, like for example this plus file, okay, so you can see this is the plus file I get from other computer. I copy it without his information. I copy it more than 25,000 plus files I have. Okay, so if you know the software number, you can search through this plus file. Okay, like for example, this number. Okay, this is the software number. So 4470860. Okay, the plus file is available, so I have to click it. Like that. And now I can copy it to show on my desktop in here. So I don't know this plus file, it can possibly transfer through email or WhatsApp something. But this is not free. So luckily, one of our company's supplier, they give us their laptop for testing of 1 week. So I have a chance to copy. Okay, this is it. I hope you get this process, but you don't need to go this process unless you understand what you are doing. Okay, so this is it. I have to go back to the cut it. You can copy all the program or the configuration of this machine, like for example machine controller, monitor, and the engine ECMN BMS main module. Okay, you can copy it one by one. Okay, so to make it sure, once did you make a reflashing or reprogram of the ECM, or you have a new ECM, okay, so do you have already the configured program of the ECM? Okay, we just only copy it there. Now, like for example, you already installed the new software. Okay, now what to do, how you can copy or how you can reinstall or reprogram the ECM? Okay, we just copy, go to the service again, service, and then copy configuration, sorry. And then select ECM replacement, and then you have to choose which program for this ECM that you USB copy before. Like for example, this is the program that I was copied before, so I have to open it by clicking double click. Okay, now this is the ECM that I was copied before. Now, how you can install it to the new ECM? Oh my goodness, Cortana, why you are open up? Okay. The only thing you can do is just choose this program ECM. Once did you click the program ECM, so the configure the program that you get from the old one EC, the old ECM. So you will be copy like this. Okay, click the program ECM and then choose the engine and then click OK. Okay, this is OK. As you can see, yeah, that's the process that you have seen. You will be seen in this procedure. Once that programming is finished, so it will show complete or finish. That's it, and then you can start the engine. Program complete. Meaning that everything is programmed based on the old program that you copy before. This is the old program that we copied before, so they only just reinstall it again, reconfigure. But what I mean, they configured the new ECM based on this program. Okay, so that's it. I hope that this video you can get a good idea as you request. Again, subscribe. Please subscribe my channel. And also don't forget to hit the notification bell, so this for a good chance for everyone that any new videos I'm going to upload, you will be notified every time, okay, by clicking the notification bell, so you will be updated or notify any videos that I'm uploaded. Okay, bye bye. Thank you for watching. Again, Caterpillar Junhang at your service.